What's up, everybody? You are watching the Litefoot Show. This is Litefoot Show number
two.
Welcome to the Litefoot Studios here up in the sky. And we're really happy to be able to do this. This has been a long time in the coming, long time in the making. And before I get any further, let me introduce to you my beautiful wife, who's also my partner in crime, my number one person on earth. And with that said, she's here with me. Whom better else could I have ever thought to do the Litefoot Show with me than the person that's with me most every day? Hopefully, if I'm lucky, she's with me. So you want to say something to the good people?
Hello, and it's awesome to get this started. I'm excited.
So just for folks that are out there listening to the podcast and not seeing this on anything, it is available for you to see on something via our YouTube channel. So that's youtube.com/Litefoot. You can actually watch this as it is a video cast as well. We're going to do both. That's part of the conundrum of what we were trying to figure out for a minute, how to do this, how to get it all squared. So we had to do a little bit more planning, more production, more everything. But we got that all figured out for you now. And, you know, with everything that we've got going on, it's something that we wanted to make sure that we could, you know, build into place so that we could come in and do this and be consistent and keep it coming for you. So, you know, every week we're going to be coming at you with a new Litefoot Show, addressing everything from points of view to current events, issues that are happening out in the community, and just really to be present and be connected.
Right.
That's the main thing that we really want to do is stay connected with everybody out there, because life for me gets so hectic, it gets so complicated, so stressed on the schedule. It's hard to be everywhere all the time. We'll get into that in a little bit, but I just wanted to say, for those of you that don't know, Litefoot, LITEFOOT.com is the website, the official Litefoot website. And by the way, CarmenDavis.com. Of course, yes. You know, we had to go out there and cop the CarmenDavis.com. Yes. Wasn't cheap. Cost a little bit of money.
Hey.
But we had dropped that, you know, we had dropped the cash on the website, right?
Right.
Get it right.
Right.
Only one Carmen Davis.
Right.
As far as I'm concerned, we had to get the .com. So Litefoot.com store for all your merchandise, everything for Litefoot. You know, we don't charge anybody anything. Nobody's paying us to do this. We just want to do it for the community. So if you like it, if you love it, if you want to support, share it. But, you know, hey, help a brother out. Buy a T-shirt if you want to.
I'm actually wearing a T-shirt today.
She is. So, well, you know. Let's see the, you know, podcast folks. This ain't gonna help you, but just jump on over to YouTube.com and you'll be able to check this out. Can we see? I don't want to touch, you know, my host or anything like that. But anyway, long story short, you can go over to thelightfoot.com/store and pick up. We got so many incredible things over there. Cell phone cases, all the way to pillows,
mugs,
to hats, the
coffee
t-shirts,
mugs,
all that good stuff. So anyway, this ain't a sales pitch for all that. I just want to say, if you want support, you want some Litefoot Chief MC headdress gear and some other cool stuff, some sayings that I always say, go over there, check that out. Follow me on Twitter at Litefoot. Follow me on Instagram at Litefoot. And of course, youtube.com/Litefoot, LITEFOOT. Subscribe, and like, and follow, and comment, and share it. I check my, I don't pawn that off onto staff or push that off to staff. If you see me commenting you on Facebook, if you see me reacting to something, that is me. It may be in a plane, it may be in a car, it may be walking down the street, it may be at 1 a.m. when I finally get a chance to focus and connect on that. But I want it to be for me. I want the engagement to be between me and you, and that's something I'm always going to feel very, very passionate about. So anyway, that's all the housekeeping stuff. I wanted to get that taken care of. Really, what I wanted to get into this is, what, you know, Carmen goes out there and she picks some topics for us to discuss. And so what is it?
I think a big one is dealing with negativity, you know, and you did
negativity.
Negativity.
People negative? There's negative people out there?
Yeah. A little bit.
Nobody watching this is negative. Y'all positive. I know you might have been thinking about putting a comment in the comment section right now about some kind of sideways thing, but y'all ain't negative. Y'all wouldn't be doing nothing negative.
A little bit. But, you know, there's also different kinds of negativity, right? I mean, there's like...
Undercover haters? That what you mean?
There's people negativity.
Internet tough guys?
And then there's, you know, unfortunate events that happen in your life, right? And
right.
Things that
being
are
negative
unexpected.
Is an unfortunate event in your life that might happen. I mean, sometimes people just get mad, right? Because, you know, life ain't going the way that they want it to go for them. And so they just want to try to crap on everybody and, you know, they just want to take it out on everybody, right? Because they made bad decisions or they made bad choices or, you know, they don't want to get up off their ass and go do some work or whatever that it may be. So everybody got to pay the price for that. Everybody got to suffer for those consequences. So is that what you mean?
That's what I mean.
That's what you mean?
Yes, right. Yes.
So how do you deal with that, man? I mean, believe me, I used to think that, you know, just when I was coming up in music, in hip hop, for those of you who don't know, you know, I'm pretty proud about the fact that, you know, I was out there doing hip hop and out there doing music when nobody was really running that in Indian country and repping. And I felt like there needed to be a voice, a native voice out there speaking about our issues and about the things that we see and unfortunately, the things that in some ways still go on to this day, but somebody had to speak about it and somebody had to get that message out there. So I definitely wanted to go do my part. And from day one, there was always people out there talking about, you know, you can't do this or what are you trying to do, you know, with hip hop music? Are you trying to make our kids, you know, something that they're not? I'm like, what are you talking about, man? Like, evolution and really getting into different spaces is what we're really trying to encourage our people to do. And you can't just, you know, bucket that as to you can only do this or you can only do that. And it seems like sometimes the only thing is you can go to college, you can go join the military, you can work for the tribe, you can powwow, you can do. It's like this set criteria of things that we can and we can't do. And outside of that, if people haven't done it before, it's like, oh, you can't go do that, or we don't do that. Like,
and
to
judgment,
me, that just seems whack.
I mean, there's just so much judgment about that, you know, and before you even, like, start, people are, like, saying stuff. So I think sometimes that, like, stops people in their tracks, you know, immediately, because they're like, oh, I don't want so-and-so to hate on me, or I don't want, you know, to have to go through that.
And I'm always saying, I could give a damn what you think,
but I think
about what I do.
Something.
You can kiss my Litefoot right square in the middle of the L between the light and the foot, just right in the middle. You can do that.
But I think something that, you know, what
and
you
by the way, for the
done,
podcast people, I keep forgetting that some people aren't watching this, right?
Right.
So that, but that's why I got to say in between the light and the foot, because they can't see that I'm putting it right.
They can't see your hands.
Right in the middle.
Right.
Right in the sweet spot, right in the middle. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Okay.
I didn't mean to cut you off.
Mm-hmm. So
I'm gonna be sleeping on the couch tonight.
I think one of the things that you've always let, whatever it is, you've always let that negative energy or anything, you've always kind of let that be fuel on the fire.
Like, haters be your motivators.
And
let your haters be your motivators.
But that's not the reason, right?
Nah,
but that's
hell
not the
no.
reason. But it's almost like, okay, you know, that's fine. You want to hate on that? That's fine. Because, and I think what gets you out of that is also the focus, mm-hmm. right? Because then at some point you got to turn that down and you got to be like, you know what? I'm going to show with my action. And not really. So that's like a big thing, I think. That's
what it's about, though. I mean, you know, the talk is cheap and people can run their mouth and they can say whatever they want. And you can't take those words to the bank and you can't take those words to anything, right?
Right.
Of any kind of value.
Right.
And get you anywhere. You know, it's about what you do and it's not about what you say. And I absolutely have. You know, I mean, and I mean, you know better than anybody. We're passionate about what we do. We really care about what we do. We really want to try to take things to the next level. I've always been that way. And I know you're always thinking that way. So when you're that passionate about something, when you're that into something, when you're that dedicated to something, when it's also who you are and it's also your family and it's also your kids.
So sometimes it does kind of, you know, it
hey,
does kind of.
Sometimes I'll be wanting to slap the freckles off people, man. I mean, I didn't grow up that way. And, you know, it's hard because, you know, you work so hard. Mm-hmm. You work and you put so much of yourself in, and your family sacrifices and your family right. pays it into that. And then people just so easily can just run their mouth or they can just say what they want to say.
Not knowing the back end and not knowing the blood, the sweat, the tears, they don't care. The sacrifices.
And they don't care. No. They don't care. No. And so for me, it is. How could you not? If you really care about it, how could you just not really... So it has been, and it will always be something that's very difficult for me right. to like
just let go sometimes.
Yeah, because you care, man. I mean, yeah. And it's like if somebody comes up and says something, or somebody says something, rah rah rah, or you hear people running their mouth. Yeah, I'm better at it today. Right. I'm better at it today than I used to be.
Right.
But I'm always going to be a little bit, it will always matter to me. Right. I guess that's really what I'm trying to say. I don't let nobody stop me. We know that.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, you know, sometimes people do. And that's why I think I speak about it so much. I think that's why we, you know, right. maybe that's why you picked this to talk about right. This second episode of the Litefoot show, that so many people do let it stop. Yeah. And so many people, I mean, look at the, you know, nationwide bullying and mm-hmm. and how vindictive people can be and how detrimental it can be to people because words are so powerful. Right. Our people have always known that words are powerful, they're strong, and they can lift you up.
Mm-hmm.
They can make you go to war. They can make you want peace. They can tear you down. They can make you feel all sorts of kind of ways. And sometimes people, man, you say the right thing at the wrong time or the wrong thing at the right time. And it can take people out, man. And we don't realize sometimes that, you know, what you say can really be very, very, very
powerful, harmful, impacting.
And really, you know, make a difference in somebody's life. And you can make a difference in a good way. You can make a difference in a bad way. And
well, I like how you, even with, you know, our kids and Sequoia, you know, our middle child, sometimes he'll kind of, you know, get a little crazy with the younger one, and you tell him, you know, are you building him up or are you tearing him down? And so, I mean, I think that's powerful to even hear too, because sometimes it's like people have to be, you know, you have to make him accountable, right? You can't just let him like bash on him. I mean, brothers will be brothers, but it's like at some point, you know, you also got to put that thought in their head.
That's right. So. You know, I mean, it's and it's something that we're going to deal with no matter where we are in life, man. I mean, let me tell you, when I started to talk about this a minute ago, I used to think people were just going to be hating, you know, because I was trying to, you know, follow my goals and make my dreams come true in hip hop and in rap and do something that I felt like could make a difference and create a platform to deliver a perspective, right, for people to be able to see something a little bit differently. And then I got into other things and movies and business and running our businesses and haters everywhere, man.
Mm-hmm. No matter what level,
I mean, you know, being in various different business pursuits, some of the things that I've experienced, you know, here in the last 5 years of my life,
right.
You'd think that some friggin' grown folks would have grown the hell up mm-hmm. and gotten out of high school, maybe some of them even preschool, and stopped the stupid and just focus on the work at hand and just do what it is you're supposed to be doing. Not right. act like a damn little kid when you're a grown ass person.
Yeah.
And so petty. People can be so friggin' petty, man. And it's, you know, you're working hard. You're doing your thing. You're right. trying to stay focused on that. And it becomes very difficult. But you got to, man. You can't let the folks out there that's running their mouth tear you down, cause you to stop. And negatively detract or take away from anything that you're doing. You got to keep pushing.
Right.
And sometimes I've learned in my life now, when it gets to be the loudest, when you mm-hmm. start hearing these people running their mouth the most,
mm-hmm.
that's when you really got to hunker down. You got to really just
focus. Well, and that's why I say
focus.
It's like it's your focus. I think that's on. I mean, just the sheer determination of you're going to get that done. And that, you know, the outside noise, I mean, that can, you know, it can be the rah-rah. And it's like you're just like you're focused. And I think that's something that we've always, you know, just focus on the work. Because that's the proof is in the pudding. Right.
Right. So. Yeah. It don't matter what you say. It matters what you do.
Right.
And at the end of the day, you know, I think that I've found that no matter where you're going to go in life, if you're always growing, if you're always pushing, if you're trying to continue to be the best you that you can be, you're going to have people that are running their mouth. You're going to mm-hmm. have people that are trying to take you out, take you down. And you just got to be that much more resilient in your focus and in your determination and your perseverance. Know what you're about. Know what matters to you the most, and keep pushing. And at the end of the day, I feel like you'll get there. Of course, I feel very strongly about my spiritual connection and the Creator, and I know we do. And
that's like the source of the strength, right? So it's like, you know, what do you do when you're faced with negativity? And sometimes as a human, you want to react kind of like you were talking about, right? It's like everybody's only human. But at a certain point, you know, you have to, okay, what are these ceremonies? What are our ways? You know, what are they teaching us? And it's like, it's outside of those ceremonies is where that really matters.
You know, and you make me think about my first time in Sundance. I remember a good friend of mine and somebody that, you know, actually helped sponsor me on the outside. One of the days that we kind of got a little bit of a break, I came out and we were talking, and she was telling me about how the ceremony is really to teach us how to be on the outside. Mm-hmm. And, you know, when you're back out in the world and when you're in that lodge, all of that you're, you know, I mean, it just, it is what it is. It's, you know, you spiritually fighting against that physical you, to overcome that so that you can strengthen your spirit and be able to do more and build your relationship with the Creator, be able to listen better. And she likened it to, you know, this world is like a hurricane. And, you know, if we stay in the center, we're fine. Mm-hmm. Because in the center of that hurricane, it's blue skies, it's calm, it's peaceful, it's sunny. But you go to the left, you go to the right, you go forward, you go backwards, you get pulled up in those incredibly torrential thunderstorms, rain, winds, and it can just suck you in and just start you into that spinning with all of that other chaos and confusion and energy. And if you allow yourself to do that, you're going to get caught up in it. But if you stay away from it and you stay in the center, and move with it and be fluid and always understand that being in the center of that energy is where that you're able to see, you mm-hmm. are able to make and move and do the things that you need to do. And I've never forgot that. So absolutely, as you grow and as you see those new kinds of hurricanes, those new kinds of storms, being able to stay in the center of all that's always going to let you be able to see and always push through. And, and you know, you can take that analogy and move it into, you know, when the weather's get rough out on the sea and, mm-hmm. you know, people turn back and they don't want to go forward and they don't want to go to that new place. And some people might just be so close to finding that island that they were supposed to be out there to go to or that they were pursuing or that they were trying. And they, within maybe 10 feet of on the other side of that darkness, they would have been there. Mm-hmm. And they turn around and go back.
Well, and I think that's kind of, you know, every action doesn't require a reaction, right? It's like just because somebody's, you know, talking smack or something doesn't mean you have to go and be part of it.
I'm still not every stupid comment on social media doesn't require a response.
And sometimes, you know, I mean, and you're pretty good about that, but sometimes I'm like, you know, just let it go. Yeah. Let it go.
Now it's, but I do want to say, you know, I mean, this is a perfect time to say those are so few and far between. And I just want to say thank you again to everybody out there in Indian country, and abroad, man. I mean, the comments are coming from around the world now, and that's just so beautiful. It's such a great feeling mm-hmm. to know you've touched people in other countries, that this world becomes a much smaller place. And it's just so awesome to see those words and to see those good things, because you know what? Nobody's underwriting this. Nobody's underwriting the expense of doing this. We're doing it because we feel like that there's a value add in this. And because also we know that our lives are about serving the community and trying to do everything that we can. And part of this is because, you know, given the crazy busy things that we have going on, and again, that's just really saying that we've been very blessed to be successful.
Right.
We've been blessed to be able to have things that we work very, very hard for. Mm-hmm. But we don't forget.
Absolutely.
We don't forget. And though for years and years and years, before we were even married, me running around all over Indian mm-hmm. country, you know, rapping, delivering a message, pushing, you know, to try to take it to the next level. And then when we got married, we did, you know, we kind of doubled up and even did it louder, faster, stronger, and powwows, like, you know, 2 and 3 powwows a week, and, you know, going out there and seeing people and visiting people performing and being on the road constantly. And then at the same time, growing a business mm-hmm. and raising a son on the road,
adding 2 more.
And then, well, that was later. That was a little bit later. You know, long story short, we were able to do it like that. You know, going to 211 events in 1 year, 54,000 miles around Indian country on the Reach the Res tour. Mm-hmm. That was something we could do at that time. Right. Man, it's hard for me to get it all in and be in one location or right. use planes today to make it from one meeting to the next meeting or one obligation to the next obligation. So in all of that.
But it's the evolution, right? And it's like but the support.
This is why we're using technology. Yes. This is why we're doing the podcast. This is why we're doing the Litefoot show. It's why I'm doing footnotes. Mm-hmm. It's why we're doing all of the outreach using social media, using technology to maintain that message and maintain that presence. So that's why we're doing this, to be able to continue to go out there and deliver the message and try to do what I know I've been born for, which is try to uplift people and help people, right. And bring people up, man, and let you know that if I've been able to do it, you can do it. And that's really what it's all about.
So let's kind of shift gears a little bit and let's kind of talk about
one last thing before I jump off of that.
Oh my God.
One last thing. This brother can talk. What I want to say is I remember seeing something about JayZ the other day, and he said, "Don't go with the flow, be the flow." Mm. And I think that's kind of what I want to wrap up that dealing with negativity, okay. man. Don't listen to all this stupid out there that people sometimes want to bring your way. Be what it's about. Don't
because
get up
you have
into
power,
it.
Right?
Don't get into
power.
Other people's stuff. Don't make your world about their world. I'm not saying don't be a good person. Don't be, you know. Somebody that's humble and that cares about what other people think and that, you know, just a good person. I'm not saying don't be a jerk and just don't talk to people and just ignore people and be that way. What I am saying is that be about your business. Be about your business. And if other people don't get it, it's other people's problem.
Right.
So we'll take that down a notch. I don't know how long we talked about 22 minutes on that.
let's switch gears for a second and let's kind of just talk about
current events.
Yes. What's going on with your boy?
My boy.
Yeah.
Hey, I got to say, man, I was in Washington, D.C., and I'm going from one meeting to the next. And I would come back to the hotel room. And the thing I wanted to get, I didn't really see it on TV, but I would get on my computer or on my phone, actually. And I would see the Conor McGregor, Mayweather face-offs and a tour around the United States, Canada. And then I think it ended up in London. But, man.
He's talking some big talk there.
Man, my dude McGregor. Hey, look, I'm all for everybody doing what they do. I ain't hating on nobody getting it. But, you know what? Sometimes when you run your mouth so much, you know, I mean, and he can back it up. I mean, Mayweather has backed it up. But I think there's some things that I mean, I'm not going to be mad if McGregor, you know, takes him and gets in that punch and makes him have to fight a whole different kind of fight that he's ever fought. And, you know, I mean, I'm a fight fan.
Yeah.
I grew up, with my parents. Actually, my dad and my grandpa were very into fighting. I remember seeing, you know, when I was really, really little, Muhammad Ali's fights and. I think it was on ABC, Wide World of Sports. They always had the fights. And, you know, growing up watching Sugar Ray Leonard and you know, I've just been a fight fan, you know, De La Hoya all the way into some of the greats, you know, watching them. And fighting is definitely a different thing than it is now. I mean, I was watching it with our son, Quana, and he's like, man, this almost seems like it's a movie. This almost seems like a scene out of a movie. Like,
well,
and I'm like,
definitely the hype. You know, the hype is, I mean, yeah, he's talking a lot.
But I got to say something about my boy McGregor. I got to say something about my boy McGregor.
The hair?
He dude had the suit just right, had the hair, you know, clean, had that dapper thing going on. And I was like, man, my dude is like, you know, he's owning it, right? He's doing it next level, about to increase his wealth 4 times. And he's feeling himself. So, all I'm saying is that, you know, if one person can run their mouth and talk, don't be mad at the guy that can match you, you know, pound for pound with the mouth. And I just hope my dude can back it up. I hope he don't go in there and chase Mayweather for, you know, all those rounds and you know, end up just doing cardio I hope they square off. I want to see Mayweather take it right on the chin from McGregor. I want to see him come back and fight more. I want to see, you know, McGregor be faster. I just want to see a good fight. You know, I'm going to pay that $99. We're going to pay. I didn't know if we had that conference yet.
If we didn't. But
I'm going to pay the $99. I'm going to watch the fight. We're going to make sure we ain't doing nothing else but, you know, McGregor and Mayweather. We're going to watch it. And I got to say, sometimes when I'm in my moments, you know, especially not so much, you know, I mean, I ain't got really, you know, all that now. Right. But I'm just saying if I was fighting, I might be a little McGregor-ish.
A little bit.
Not. I mean, he being a little crazy. I mean, not some of the stuff he's doing. I know that people are saying something about how he talking about, you know, some of the negative stuff he said about, you know, racial almost stuff and whether it was actually racist kind of based.
Yeah.
I wouldn't. None of that. I'm not talking about that.
Right,
I'm just saying.
Right.
If I was in that fight and I was in that situation, I'd be feeling myself a little bit. I'd be like, you know what, bro? I didn't take this fight to lose.
Right.
I'm not mad at somebody that thinks that they can win. But like we've been talking about, talk's cheap. You got to be able to back it up.
Yes.
Got to be able to back it up.
Yes.
Be careful. You know, I mean, I remember my dad talking about don't write any checks with your mouth that your rear end can't cash.
Yeah.
You know, because you can end up owing the bank a lot of money and you can't make them payments and somebody going to come collect pretty quick. So anyway. I hope y'all, you know, decide whether or not you want to watch it. Of course, you know, the last thing I want to see is to be a 30-second fight. I'm not going to be so mad, though, if he knocks Mayweather out in 30 seconds. If that happened, I wouldn't be mad.
You know, I'm not either. I mean, I'm not.
I'm not hating on Mayweather.
I'm not hating on him either, because you know what? I mean, look at his record, right? It's like
you can't knock,
numbers don't lie. But you know, my dad always said, you know, he's always going to root for the underdog. And so that's kind of my thing right now too. It's like, you know what, like let him have his chance. Let him have that shine.
Maybe it was some of that stuff when I saw him bring the flag out. Right.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking to myself, man, I wish we had some like native person that was like at that level,
right,
being one of the best. And shout out to Comanche Boy. I know we got people out there that's been doing it and done some incredible things in boxing and had the great opportunity to work with Comanche Boy and really, you know, help
the
brother out with
great
doing
guy.
Stuff and booking him around the country and helping him get out there. He's got a great message. So definitely check out Comanche Boy. But I'm talking about when you get to that level where it's like the world premier fight.
Right.
And it's the two best in the world in their respective divisions or whatever going to go fight each other and see what it really comes down to. And when I saw him getting the flag and putting it on and repping his homeland, and when I heard people singing those songs to him on stage, I just kind of felt, you know, like there was some definite connectedness to what was going on there and some cultural, you know, things that I saw happening that I just wanted to relate to. And I saw that now when I saw Mayweather go over and pick up the flag and start being disrespectful.
Right.
I think that's probably what started leaning me more towards McGregor because I was like, yo, man, this is just some stuff you don't do.
Right.
And that's where it would have kind of got sideways.
Yep.
I probably would have got the book bag, the bag in Toronto and thrown all his money out into the crowd if he would have done that with the flag from our people. I would have had to get a little bit more.
Right. There's just some things you don't disrespect.
So you know? God bless McGregor for not, you know, spending a little, not even a little eeny weeny. I don't even know how to like describe that. Like Mayweather got money, right? So, you know, throwing away a big stack.
It's nothing.
Ain't nothing. But long story short, man. Yeah, let's get off it. I do want to talk a little bit about Jay-Z's 444. Man. So many times, man, I'm listening to hip hop, and I know we got a son that's always listening to hip hop, and hip hop is a huge obviously it's a huge part of our life. Did I say obvious?
Obvious.
Yeah, I'm getting to that point in this show that I'm like starting to cut things off. Obviously, it is a big part of our life for obvious reasons, right?
Right.
And so, you know, long story short, I, you know, I'm not hating on, you know, any, you know, whatever. But look, man, come on, bro. Like some of this stuff that's out there right now, I mean, it would just never cut the mustard before. And I feel like there are some components in hip hop that, you know, you got to keep in the culture. You got to keep in the music. And mm-hmm. and I feel like that's just getting watered down and it's getting thrown out. And we've almost kind of got into punk rap, really. And nobody's calling it that yet. Yeah. But it is kind of punk rap. It's like, it's almost like all the iterations that rock and roll went through mm-hmm. with the various different forms of it. I think hip hop, well, I don't know if you can call it hip, even close to that, but rap is going into those iterations now. And I guess that's growth. That's evolution of the music. It's making it, you know, broader. It's growing the spectrum out there. So, you know, good for that. But what I wanted to say is I think it was good to have somebody like Jay come back with the record that really got back to what it's all about. You know, people were talking about that the music's whack and no ID, really didn't come with the beats and all that. But you know what? Look, I feel like, you know, kudos to Jay for being able to say, you know what, this is what I like. I'm staying in my lane. I mm-hmm. do what I do. Mm-hmm. I'm not trying to go out there and do the fresh flavor of what's happening right now with whatever's most popular. Right. I'm going to do what I do.
Because he's not 20 either, right? He's not trying to act like he's 20.
But at the end of the day, he's doing what's true to him, what makes it universally powerful. Mm-hmm. When you do you, what's personal is universal.
Right.
And I feel like what he's doing personally is translating universally. And shout out to him, man, for doing what he does.
And also for kind of being honest, right? I mean, for putting it out there.
I knew you was going to bring that up.
I mean,
Thank you for making your own lemonade, Jay. We just call that raspberry lemonade.
He had to come back with that, though, right?
Like blueberry lemonade. Some kind of lemonade.
With lemonade, I mean, you just can't, you know.
I was kind of thinking, you know, for a minute there, I mean, they're smart folks, man. I thought maybe they just got into a fight or said they got into a fight or that he did something and that they just trying to sell. And you know what? The jury is out. We don't know if any of this is true. But it is something that people inquiring minds want to know, right? So they have taken the tabloid, you know, stuff, and maybe they've put a little bit into that. But people do want to know, and mm-hmm. and so if it is real, thank you for being honest. Thank you for you know, kind of putting it out there and letting people see inside, and letting it be a very personal album for both Beyonce and Jay-Z.
Right.
But if it ain't, then you know, y'all some good marketers. y'all know how to sell some records, man. You know, and I got to say shout to Jay for, you know, just being such a thorough professional to be able to be out there writing on his record 2 weeks before it comes out. Mm-hmm. And again, I mean, that's just so awesome that technology has allowed us to do that. I mean, the best way to not leak your album is to not wrap it until you're going to put it out in a week. You know, I mean, that's brilliant, man. And shout for him for all the business stuff he's doing. You know, with Sprint and Tidal, and the way that he's found to get these corporations to come to him to make money. Take notes, man.
Right.
Take notes.
He's trendsetted some barriers. That's for sure. You know, it's
absolutely. And well, he's trendsetting and he's you know, pushing through barriers.
Yeah.
Both. And to see him do that, I remember back when cats that were rapping were getting ridiculed for doing shoe deals,
mm-hmm.
that they were sellouts.
Like MC Hammer.
Well, I mean, Hammer and other folks out there I mean, Master P had a doll. I think if I'm not mistaken, British Knights.
Yes.
You know, and then now you look at all these guys doing shoe deals and doing different clothing deals.
I mean, Pepsi. I mean, all the
if you were anywhere close to doing some of those things, you were a sellout and not keeping it real. Mm-hmm. I mean, even acting. Mm-hmm. And now it's almost like that's part of your, you know, progression as an artist in hip hop now, is that at some point in time, you will get into acting. I just want to say I was on that shit from day one. Please. Thank you. Thank you.
But a lot of people actually thought that you were an actor first.
Let them think it.
I mean.
Thank it. Thank
but
it.
But it's always been the music. It's always,
been the music first, man. I was out there running them streets all over this country doing what I mm-hmm. do, traveling all over the United States, and then got a movie.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, let the record be straight on that. We was out there thinking about that, you know, from day one. And when that opportunity came, we had to take it. So we've been ahead of that, you know, stuff for a minute. And we're going to keep doing it. We're going to keep doing it. We're going to do all of it, man. We're going to do all of it. We just do it our way now. with our stuff and right. make our own productions. Right. So anyway, let it be a testament to anybody out there that wants to do it. You do it, man. There's never been a better time in technology for you to be able to do what you want to do and make it happen how you want to have it happen. Let the world hear your voice. You've got a great opportunity, better right. than any
well,
time
I mean,
on Earth.
I think, you know, especially with like how remote some of our communities are, right? And it's kind of like that's been, you know, the thing that's been the challenge is how remote. And it's like now with the internet, with, you know, everything at your fingertips, basically. I mean, obviously, there's still communities where they don't have the broadband and with, you know, computers and so on. But I mean, there's more of an opportunity than there has ever been.
Right.
Because of all of these things. So technology, right. I mean, it's huge.
Hey, man, don't no excuses, man. You either make an excuse or you make a way. Make right. a way, man. Make right. a way. So I do want to get into a little bit of speaking about some events out there. I want to talk a little bit about, you know, what I'm really seeing out there is a tremendous attack on sovereignty. A lot of court rulings, a lot of the attitudes and behaviors of folks out there in the federal government. Of course, people that are out there listening and paying attention to the budget mm-hmm. That's come mm-hmm. down that will literally eliminate programs, eliminate right. Subsequently opportunity, whether it is for business or it is for healthcare or is mm-hmm. for housing or whatever that it is. There's never been a more important time for Indian country to realize a dependency is not sustainable.
Right.
And I have still to this day not figured out how you can be independently codependent.
Yeah.
You're either independent or you're codependent. And we got to start looking at the ways that we can make ourselves independent. We have to start looking at the ways that we can rise above basically these chains that bind us. I mean, I don't want to sound, you know, cliche, but at the end of the day, we got to look at, ain't nobody coming for us, man.
Right.
Ain't nobody coming for us. And if we're going to make a better day, if we're going to make a better way, if we're going to teach our kids something different, we can't do the same old broke things and keep, you know, thinking that that's going to get us to a different end result. I mean, that's the definition of insanity, right?
Right.
You
yep.
keep doing the same things over and over again, expecting a different result, and it's not going to happen. Right. So long story short,
I think we also have to have like really honest conversations and dialogue about sovereignty, right? And the meaning of sovereignty. And our meaning of sovereignty is different than the government's meaning and definition of sovereignty. And I think that's something that it's like we have to be honest about that because we're not at that place that sometimes we think we are, right? And it's
preach.
It sucks.
Preach.
I mean, because in 2017, you would want something, you know, you would hope that we'd be further on down the road.
And we got to, at some point in time, call it like we see it.
Right.
And if it ain't that, then don't call it something else.
Right.
And be real with it because, you know, how can you fight what it is if you ain't willing, if you're not willing to recognize it for what it is? And keep wanting to tell yourself it's something different. I think we have to have the courage. We have to have the strength. We have to know that we're good enough, that we're capable enough, and that we're able as a people to push through those things and get to a different end game.
And I think the power is in unity, in unification. You know, I mean, that's
is
the power.
Absolutely, 1,000%. And there's never been anybody I've ever listened to or anything that I've ever seen or even in my community, in your community, in our communities that right. didn't understand that we're better together.
Absolutely.
But I think we also have to think about defining for ourselves what sovereignty means. And I know that there will be a lot of people that are listening to this. We've already done that. That is a moving target. That is something that we have to continue to evolve with. And yes, there's some core fundamentals of it that will never, 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 never change. Mm-hmm. But we have to continue to look forward to the future to see if we are a part of progression or if we're a part of stagnation. Are we moving or are we standing still expecting people to come to us? And the world's going on, man. The world's moving. And I'm not saying that, you know, any way, shape, fashion, or form, you know, people can say what they want to say, but we have the challenge is, and I've heard this from day one, is walking in both worlds. It's to never forget who you are, but it's to continue to move forward. It's to continue to evolve and to show the resiliency of who we are as a native people and strong people, people with a culture, a people with tradition, a people with ties to this land, unlike anybody else. But at the same time, we have to make sure that we are also being willing to be open and being willing to be a partner, because we can talk all of this we want about what we need and what we need to see happen in the community. But if we aren't open to other people working with us to get to a better day,
that's a good point.
We haven't ever learned from what other people's struggles have been, because it took a lot of other people to get folks from one place to another place. And sometimes we want to talk about Indian country with Indian country, about Indian country to Indian country, and then come back around and repeat all those steps again. And like, how are we going to make this a world issue? How are we going to make this a issue that other people understand? What are we doing to, I mean, when have you seen a commercial about any of the things that are going on in Indian country on a major network across the country? Yeah. When have you seen a commercial about the struggle? And I'm not saying you do it to where you point the finger. I'm just saying bring some awareness, bring some enlightenment. Yeah. Some folk come together that got the money to be able to do that and create a message that brings people together, that helps people want to know more, that brings people to the plight. Mm-hmm. So that they can know more about it and help in ways that maybe we can't alone do that.
Building those bridges, things. Really.
Creating partnerships, creating mutually beneficial partnerships. And I think we're doing that in some ways, but there's so much more opportunity out there, I think, for us to do that at a much higher level and really get out there and engage and move forward and teach our young people that's one of the most powerful things you can do. And you have the ability, you're strong enough, you're capable enough to be able to be somebody that is meaningful, not just in your community, but to the world, that you can be a powerful person in the world. And sometimes I think, you know, just by what I see, by what I have traveled and seen, sometimes people feel like they're lost if they're not geographically within the confines of their community. And I don't think the Creator is just in one square block.
Yeah.
I don't think the Creator is just in one region. The Creator is everywhere.
Right.
And wherever we are, if we choose to live our life that way, the Creator is there too.
Yeah.
So, you know, I don't want to get off, you know, I don't want to get on a rant, but
it's here.
I'm passionate about it, man. I mean, I really do want to see it be different. I want to see it be better. I mean,
no,
for
me
people
too.
Out there that's watching this, you know, it's important, man. It's important that we're not like this anomaly to people, that we're not single faceted, that people understand how multifaceted we are and how dynamic we are and how beautiful that is.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not just this one thing that everybody always tries to lump it into. And sometimes we even do that, you know, without even realizing it.
Right.
But,
to each other.
That's not, you know, I don't believe my ancestors and my relatives were that way. I don't think they were just one trick ponies and they just did one thing and that's what they did. I think that the Creator made them everything. And I believe that's why we should remember that and we should embrace that and we should be about that.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, nobody's going to come to me and tell me, you know, you can't do this or you can't do that, or because you're this, you can't do this. Nah, man, if it's what the Creator put me here on this earth to do and the opportunity presents it and it speaks to my soul and it speaks to what it is that's right, I'm out, man. I'm gone.
But
I'm going to go get it.
That requires, you know, a shift, right? A shift in the way that you think. And, you know, sometimes that's hard. People don't want to change. And I think that's one of the things that we also have to look at as well, is how do we make that shift, you know? And like you said, it's not about losing yourself and losing your identity. It's about holding on to your identity and moving forward in today's world.
Absolutely. Are you married?
I am married.
You want to get married? You dating? Tell your husband I'm coming over and we're going to have a conversation. We're gonna have to talk.
Okay, let's
don't just get rattled
well,
right now.
Also, no, let's kind of shift.
Let's do this. Let's do this because
this is compromising.
I feel kind of in a way, yeah. Because I'm just gonna flip switch and like go a whole nother direction right now. I think one of the things, obviously, that has always attracted me to you, and you know, why I feel like, you know,
I'm trying to get extra points right now.
why you know, that girl, you, okay, that woman, okay, you that person. I think it's important that we bring that voice to this. I mean, one of the reasons why we have you on here and why you wanted to be on here and why we thought it was a great idea is to bring your perspective to all of these things. So I think we should do this segment. This is the beautiful thing about being an owner. Beautiful thing about being an owner. You can call your own shots. Do what you want to do. I think we should have like a what ladies say. You know, something that's a part of the Litefoot show, that you talk about what you want to talk about how you see in the world, about things that you see out there. I know we had a conversation, so because I'm bringing this on, I don't want you to think I'm like putting you out on the spot.
Because
this
does.
Is video. People seeing this right now in real time happening.
He always puts me on the spot.
But she's like, that's so awesome. It's so awesome. I just never know. You're mysterious. You're moving.
Yeah.
Don't know what's going to happen.
Try to be a...
Might be a candlelight dinner. Might be a boat ride. Might be...
You
so
never
we trying
know.
To we trying to keep
you
it we trying
know.
To keep that going here on the Litefoot show. So long story short, there I saw it, and I think this actually even happened a few months back, right?
What are we talking about here?
Is it Brook Power?
Oh yeah,
Brook Power.
Yes.
So this immediately became controversial. Young lady from Hawaii. I honestly don't know her tribe.
She's Ojibwe, I think.
So hey, look. I think this is something we should talk about. I think it's something we should talk about.
Absolutely.
Because a lot
of
people.
It's a hot topic. It's a hot topic, and people have, you know, mixed emotions on it, right?
So for people out there that don't know what we're talking about, shout out to Brook Power.
She's the first Native American to be Playmate of the Year for Playboy.
Right.
And, you know, there was, I think. To start it off, you know, I saw this website kind of put it out there, and they were like, you know, is this the way they position? I can't remember, but the way they positioned it immediately caused you to have a judgment, right? And to me, as a woman, I felt that was wrong. Because I felt like, you know, it's like, of course people are going to have that judgment and people are going to have their feelings and, you know, right, wrong, whatever. But I just felt like the way they posed that question, I mean, it made me feel bad for her kind of. I mean, she's putting herself out there, but it was kind of just one of those things where it's like, how can you get a, you know, right... a positive response? You know, it all was turning negative.
I'm for people rising up, accomplishing what it is they've been put on this earth to do, you know, whatever that may be. I can't say what somebody else's path is, you know, what they get from, you know, point A to point B to be able to accomplish. I believe she's now been in many major fashion lines, photo shoots. She's probably been in some commercials, I think, at this point in time. I think she's actually getting into acting now.
I think one of the big things, though, and I think we should address this as well, is that I think a lot of people were kind of, you know, jumping on it because our women have the highest rates of domestic violence.
Right.
And so you absolutely have to acknowledge that. And you know, I'm absolutely against that and, you know, would never want to.
There's like this objectification, right?
Right. And so I think that's something where, you know, on one hand, it's that. But then on the other hand, you know, I mean, I think our people have... We're just not out there, right? So it's like anybody that goes out there, and you know, maybe this was her dream, right? And just because she's Native doesn't necessarily mean that, you know, oh well, we don't do that. You know, that's not our ways, or that's not traditional to, you know, to show your body. And so there's many different thoughts,
right?
On that,
I think that you know what it made me think about, right, is. I think you're amazing. Obviously, that's why we're married. I feel like, you know, you're, I'm going to go on the record here. I think you're hot.
Thank you.
I think, you know, I think you're bomb. I mean, I'm going to take it back to the 90s with that word.
Wow.
But I we did a video for one of my songs called My Chick.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like that video was just us,
just being
us and being in love and being, you know, free to be able to do what we want to do and how we want to do it and just being about us.
Right.
And also recognizing the real fact that other guys look at you and they like, you know, oh my gosh, she's hot. And I'm like, okay, fine. I'm not jealous. Right.
Right.
I'm like, you know, she is. Right. She
right.
is. And so I wrote a song.
Yeah.
I wrote a song that said that.
Right.
And then we did a video. And you would have thought that you were naked in the video.
Right.
It was the most friggin' tame friggin' video on earth.
It was.
And people like, oh my God, look at she's like the way she's like, what are you talking about?
Yeah.
Like, I remember people saying that, you know, I mean that video, people paid attention to that video in ways mm-hmm. I didn't ever think people would pay attention to
right.
that video. And I'm like, are you nuts? Have you seen a Beyonce video?
Right.
Have
Which
you seen
crazier.
A Rihanna video?
Right.
Have you seen a, I could go on and on
J-Lo.
And on.
J-Lo.
J-Lo, booty, like booty out, not even booty kind of out.
And I was covered. Like, I mean, I didn't,
there,
you
there
know.
Was nothing about you that was like, I mean, it's like little to the imagination. Have you seen the concert tours?
Right.
The performances of folks.
Of other
and
people.
And I'm just sitting here thinking to myself, like, come on, man. Really?
Yeah.
Really? Really? Like, that's what that is. Like, we can't compete on a level to where it's like we just expressing ourselves and it be tame. And y'all want to, like, go there with, oh, my God, it's objectification. And, you know, it's just, oh, come on, man. Really? I think, to me, at some point in time, if it's not the person saying, oh, I don't want to do that. And then if they're forced to do
sure.
it, or they feel like the only opportunity or the only option is to do it. But if you're just doing you, if you're just like feeling yourself and you feel like this is just, I'm cool with it. I'm this is who I am. Then do what you do.
Mm-hmm.
Do what you do. And I feel like, you know, for us to be so, you know.
I just felt bad because, you know, I think as a woman, I mean, of course, there's always double standards, right? Especially for women and, you know, in the workplace and, you know, and what we're supposed to do traditionally and our roles traditionally. And I'm all for that. You know what I mean? I think, you know,
you
in
live
our
it.
Marriage,
you live it.
I mean, it's like it's. We do because it's you have a role, I have a role, and it's like that's what keeps everything. Why are you looking at me crazy?
No, I mean, I'm
it,
just
it
thinking.
Keeps it, it keeps it in harmony. It keeps balance. And I believe, I strongly believe in those things. I just felt bad because, you know, I mean, she's doing her thing. She's a beautiful girl. And
woman.
Woman. And I just think that, you know, if that's what she wants to do, if that's her path and she wants, I mean, she did it, you know, and that's her choice. And
right.
everybody has a choice. And I just, you know,
you know,
I mean,
it just
kudos
makes you think,
to her, yeah. I think, you know, and support to her. I mean, nobody said, hey, you know, so-and-so don't run for Miss Indian, you know, or Miss USA, or nobody said those things because you have to go out in your swimsuit, or nobody, you know, it's just, I mean.
It starts to become a contradiction.
It does.
It starts to become hypocritical. And I'm just saying, you know, we're talking about being in movies and we're talking about getting out there more as Native people. And what happens the first time we get a woman that's cast in a leading role that requires her to be in a love scene with the leading man and there's nudity or there? I mean, what are
I mean,
we
like,
going to
like,
do? Are you
like
going to
Halle
turn
Berry, right? I mean, she was like, she did it.
You know,
and
I
that,
mean,
and that
I'm,
was her
I'm not
choice.
Saying that you just do it like it's some if
like
it's
you
part
have
of the
to
story,
it.
If it's part of the story and it's an incredibly good script with an incredible cast with an incredible director that really there's truth in it and the story is that if that's a part of it, there's no difference to me than a good movie that requires you to go out and use a gun as a cop or use a gun as a whatever your character is doing or whatever that mm-hmm. also could be, you know, negatively perceived or mm-hmm. or received. And I think we just have to be a little bit more open, man. I'm not saying that you know, what I am saying is that if that's what speaks the truth to her, she got to do what she got to do.
Well, and I think that, I mean, reading some of those comments, you know, I just felt like we weren't helping her. Or you know, it's like we joined in, right? And everybody has
I didn't,
their
well, don't,
voice.
When you say we.
No, I didn't join in.
I wouldn't,
but
you ain't gonna
I
be
was,
finding no comments from me.
No, but everybody kind of that commented, You know, I mean, kind of goes back to what you were saying. It's like you can uplift somebody or you can tear them down.
And ladies and gentlemen, that brings us full friggin' circle back to the thing we opened up this Lightfoot show number
dealing with negativity.
Let your haters be your congratulators.
And I think at the end of the day, it's about doing you and doing what, you know, if you're passionate about it and you're doing something, you're making a positive difference, you're not hurting anybody else, you're not out there. I mean, you got to do you.
So shout to at, I think it's at Brook Power. I'm not sure. I would imagine it is. If it was me, I would have it at Brook Power. But, you know, check her out on Instagram, on Twitter. You can check us out at Lightfoot, at I, Carmen Davis, on Twitter, on Facebook.
Instagram.
Facebook also, iCarmenDavis, Facebook.com/iCarmenDavis. And then on Snapchat, I mean, believe me, all my Snapchat people out there, I am really honestly trying.
I'm trying. Guys.
I'm trying to get him on there to snap.
And
but please understand, with everything else I got to do every single day, I'm keeping my Instagram story up most of the time. I'm posting. We got everything out there. We're doing like that. We're filming the, you know, footnotes. We got the Lightfoot Relentless Pursuit coming back. We got the Lightfoot show now with the podcast.
No excuses. I'm not making no excuses.
But, you know, look, man, the snap is just like the camel on the, or the camel on the straw. The straw on the camel's back. I'm telling you, it's just a little bit tough sometimes. So long story short, I just want to give a shout out to all of the folks that have had me in their community recently. My Choctaw people out there in Oklahoma at the Choctaw Small Business Academy. Thank you for having me keynote. The Eastern Band of Cherokee that came out here to Seattle, had me come and speak to the youth. A shout out to everybody there. Thank you for that. Upper Skagit.
Cedro Willie, I'm from Oklahoma, man.
I mean, that looks like Cedro to me. Cedro Willie, what's up?
Cedro Willie.
Upper Sioux community
in Minnesota.
Thank you so much. Department of Energy hosted the National Tribal Energy Summit a couple months back, and then the ability to go out 3 affiliated and give remarks at their college commencement.
Right.
And to speak at that, thank you so much. I'm going to continue to remain out there in the community. Go to Lightfoot.com for all the latest on the upcoming dates and events of where we're going to be. And again, Lightfoot.com/store. If you appreciate the show, if you appreciate the footnotes, if you appreciate what we do out there, please, you know, support and check it out.
And we have some amazing new gear coming, Native Style. You know, we have
NativeStyleClothing.com.
Yes.
So much stuff. I mean, it is a lifestyle brand now for sure. And so many things. Again, you know, leggings for women on the way, socks, cell phone cases, pillows to decorate your home,
totes,
caps, beanies, tank tops, girly tees, women's tees, baby's clothes, t-shirts, sweatshirts, crew neck zips, hoodies, you name it, man. We're bringing it to you. So Twitter, Instagram, at Lightfoot, LITEFOOT. And please subscribe to YouTube, on my YouTube channel, youtube.com/Lightfoot. Subscribe.
And please share, too. Please share, share, comment,
spread it around.
Like.
Spread it around.
Spread
show
love.
Some love. We are about to wrap up our first hour-long podcast. I just want to say thank you again to everybody out there watching the YouTube channel, watching all the content that we're creating for you. This is why we do it. We do it for you. We want to remain engaged. We want to be able to stay out there and make sure our voice is heard. It's very, very hard sometimes to get out there physically and be in all those different locations around the United States, but this is a way that we can do it and use the internet technology and, of course, the awesome tools we have with YouTube and Facebook and all that good stuff to stay out there and make sure the message is heard and that we stay connected to you, because that's what it's all about for us.
And stay tuned for the next Lightfoot podcast.
That's
stay
right.
Stay tuned.
Lightfoot Show number 3 coming next week.
Yes.
We have 59 minutes and 18 seconds, 19 seconds. And again, subscribe, like, follow, comment, share. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And we out.
Thank you. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. The Lightfoot Show. It was all a dream.